Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we'll start by looking at launches with the SAOCOM-1B launch and Starlink 11 delay. There's also a bit of Boca Chica, a bunch of information from Elon Musk, as well as SN6 and SN7.1 testing. So let's head straight in and get up to date. On Sunday, SAOCOM-1B along with two rideshare payloads launched to space with B-1059 lifting off for the fourth time. This was also the first polar orbit mission from Florida since the 60s.
Zero. Ignition. And liftoff of Falcon's first East Coast polar launch, Hola Argentina.
This booster then came back down to perform a beautiful, picture-perfect landing at LZ-1.
And you could not ask for a better landing than that. Falcon 9 has landed once again. That is number 4 for this first stage booster and the 58th overall of an orbital class rocket.
Here's another amazing video from SpaceX of the Falcon 9 landing. Eric Berger tweeted something interesting, saying SpaceX required 7 years to go from its first to its 10th launch. In 7 more years, SpaceX has gone from its 10th to its 100th. This is what acceleration looks like. I can't wait to see where we are in 7 more years. So even though SAOCOM-1B launched on Sunday, Starlink 11 was unfortunately delayed. SpaceX has since tweeted that they are targeting tomorrow, September 3rd, for the next Starlink launch. Heading to Boca Chica, whilst not much has changed, work is progressing with the orbital launch mount. Over at the production area, just to the side of the tents, they've been pouring some concrete. Further work down on the ground has been taking place over by the old Gaswell lot. We have some interesting things that look to me to be pipes sticking out of the ground. The roll lift has seen some action recently as it prepares to move another Starship test tank. It's likely preparing to roll the SN7.1 prototype down the road, but more on that in a little bit. There's also the high bay for Super Heavy, which is almost complete with the final level put together. Just need to finish the walls, add a roof, and then they should be pretty much ready for action, and Super Heavy might grow quickly. So on Monday, there was a Humans to Mars summit where Elon Musk dialed in from Germany to answer some questions. One of the things Musk said was, "We are making good progress. The thing that really impedes progress on Starship is the production system. A year ago was nothing there, and now we've got quite a lot of production capability, so we are rapidly making more and more ships." He also talked about Super Heavy and its Raptor engines. He said they will probably change the amount of engines the booster has again. SpaceX is trying to simplify the configuration of Starship's Super Heavy booster, so the engine configuration might end up being 28 instead of 31 engines. In terms of Super Heavy, somebody tweeted about the thrust to weight ratio of an engine. Musk responded to say the outer ring of booster engines 20 out of 28 have no thrust vector control actuators. Steering control comes from the center 8 TVC and differential throttle of the outer engines. By any measure, the high thrust variant of Raptor will probably have the highest thrust to weight of any engine ever. Also, Musk mentioned during the interview when Super Heavy construction would begin. He said they would be starting on the first prototype booster this week. I absolutely can't wait to see the first Super Heavy booster. This brings me onto my next points, where we'll take a look at some bits and pieces spotted here and there. First up, there was the arrival of these new aerosurface covers that were seen on the back of a trailer. There's also a whole load of stainless steel rings that have been seen lined up outside. I'm thinking and really hoping that these could be the first pieces of Super Heavy we are seeing. Also, as of lately, a whole load of forklifts have been carrying new rolls of stainless steel into the construction yard. Anyhow, moving on to Starships, starting with SN6, you will know that they were targeting Sunday and began preparing for a test. Unfortunately, the first attempt had to be aborted and vehicles were seen heading to the pad. However, around an hour or so later, the pad was once again cleared and SpaceX began fueling the prototype. Again though, the SN6 hop test on Sunday was aborted once more and delayed by a few days. This brings us to now, where we have more road and beach closures scheduled. You can see there is a primary date of tomorrow, September 3rd, for the hop with backup dates of Friday and Saturday. So hopefully this tank will hop this week. Being worked on a lot recently, we have SN7.1, and here you can see the upper dome was spotted attached to a crane. It was then moved out of the fabrication tent and lifted to be joined with the rest of the tank section. Now, engineers are working in and around the test tank to get it fully welded and prepared for testing, which should be happening very soon. In the last road closures image for SN6, you would have seen more testing dates. SN7.1 is expected to be rolled out to Pad B soon and placed on top for some pressure testing. Right now, there is a primary closure date of Sunday, September 6th, with backup dates of Monday and Tuesday. This will be another bopper to test the new 304L stainless steel along with the new thrust puck, I believe. I have to say an enormous thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Gal for her time and effort going out there to film this awesome footage. Also, an enormous thank you to the whole of the NASA spaceflight team who do an incredible job bringing us fantastic space coverage. These detailed and frequent updates would not be possible without you. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.